January 19th of 1862, sir.
It was a really tough time period.
They stayed wet. They especially the Confederate Army, didn't have a lot to eat. They foraged for a lot of food.
Keep your head down. We'll come through this just fine. God bless every one of you.
Well, the Union had a big advantage.
One of the sad things about it is people today, you know, in our society, have forgotten.
I mean, we're not even close to what really happened, but it's, you get a taste.
Two or three generations, that's not really that long ago.
No other hobby that I know of that makes you want to learn, picks you up and drives you to the library.
If you ask around, just go through here and ask some of these kids, they have no idea about Civil War.
To the rear and open order!
We're gonna drive them boys back today.
We sit out here for, you know, 3 days, you know, we just wore plumb out. You couldn't go to work and work as hard as what we do out here.
Most engagements, if a regiment is fully involved, we're talking 40 or 50% casualties.
Now you may have killed somebody who later on could have found a cure for cancer.
Reenacting to me, you know, has really been a big part of my life.
It's fun trying to correct misconceptions, misperceptions. We're not being paid to do this, we're doing it because we love it.
It's something that we really need to remember just so that it never, ever happens again because it was so devastating.
Everywhere, and they'll deliver it right to your door.
And that's why Jim Davis is hoping United Parcel Service workers won't strike. He owns the Indoor Bonsai Company and ships hundreds of plants worth thousands of dollars all over the world using UPS.
Well, it can basically almost shut me down. I can ship with other alternative means, but it's either really cost prohibitive or the time factor involved.
Time is the key. Bonsai plants can be fragile, and if not delivered within days of packing, many could die. In the days to come, Jim Davis has hundreds of bonsai plants to ship out, but the real concern are the 200 or so he just shipped out today. And if UPS goes on strike, his customers won't get their merchandise, and he'll be out hundreds of dollars.
They got to think about their customers. It can be like baseball. They go on strike a couple times, their customers will find somebody else to start using.
5 miles, no sweat, 6 miles,
You little doggone wake-up recruit, you better wake up and get with the program!
Stare into the eyes of a female recruit, and you'll see the same determination as their male counterparts.
I jabbed them, I knocked her down, it was wonderful.
The Marine Corps is a different corps than your father or grandmother remember. The ideals are the same, God, Corps, Country. But this is a kinder,
did I say move?
Friendlier core.
My whole platoon could whip a platoon of males.
Today, drill sergeants aren't allowed to touch a recruit or verbally harass them. It doesn't make boot camp any easier. Nearly a quarter of all females will quit.
Yes, sir!
Nearly double the number for men. So why do they keep coming?
I wanted a challenge, and I wasn't ready for college yet, and I didn't want to waste my parents' money.
And you got a lot of them that are just complete Marine Corps, and you got a lot of them that just come into the Marine Corps just to get away from their families.
It's 2 a.m. Another busload of female recruits arrives at Parris Island. They come from across the country to plant their feet in the yellow footsteps and see if they can endure the longest and possibly toughest boot camp in the military.
This is your first step in becoming a member of the world's finest fighting force.
Soon, they're stripped of their civilian clothes and marched in for fatigues. For the next 12 weeks, every minute of their lives is controlled by a stranger they'll call ma'am. To be part of an amphibious fighting force, they'll have to swim 50 meters wearing 40 pounds of gear.
Go ahead, pull yourself out.
Cover on the line now!
They'll run miles and drill.
You're messing it up because you're going too fast!
Learn hand-to-hand combat with pugil sticks instead of M16s to learn to kill the enemy.
drill some more, and strain to meet the minimum physical standard the Marines believe is required to become combat ready. Tomorrow night, you'll meet recruit Heather Etchen of Wilmington. She'll tell you about the mental and physical stress she wanted to endure to become a Marine. At Parris Island, South Carolina, Kevin Landers, 19 News.
Time is the most important factor.
The question of how to get the patient as quickly as they could to a facility like university.
There's times you come home and you just hug your child and think, oh, please.
I really can't remember a day where I said I really didn't want to go into work.
I love it. The scene fights are exciting because you get to actually do an impact, because that's what, you know, air care is for.
You know, I think a lot of people in this area take air care for granted.
Tenton Air Care 1, respond. Adams County Hospital, West Union, Ohio.
Okay, here we go.
We go to Adams County and Hillsborough probably 5 to 8 times a week. There's not a lot of expertise and high level of care out there.
This is Brockton County Dispatch. We have a bad accident. We need air care.
Tenton Air Care 2, we have a activation to Brockton County on the AA Highway.
It's probably one of my least favorites.
I do know that there is an amputee.
Yes, it was a really bad one.
As far as I was told, it was two ladies that were struck by a car.
And I saw her, examined her, thought that she needed urgent transport to trauma center.
The patient has bilateral open, 15 fractures, tender abdomen. Patient has no pulse in the lower extremity.
Things stick out in my mind are things that are very sad.
And you just get so busy doing that you don't stand back and think about how sad it is until you come back. And then you kind of sit down and go, oh, that was sad.
Some folks drive by and said, hey, if you're going back to Cincinnati tonight, you're a fool. You're not going to make it. The AA Highway has become impassable.
Well, Gina, there doesn't appear to be any consensus among city council members about what's best to build on the property just west of the suspension bridge.
And they do hope that sonar equipment will pinpoint at least where the boat is at, so search crews will have a general idea of where Larry Brunson's body is at.
Here's the way things shaped up today, and it looks like another gorgeous day across the area. Look at this beautiful sunset. Gotta thank Matt Foxworthy for that. Boy, as the night goes on, but for right now, it appears that we are going to be dealing with cloud cover. This is a pretty shot from English, Kentucky. Matt Foxworthy got it a stream there, and the train going by, a lovely, lovely shot there. Well, across the region, there they are, and look what the clouds were doing. This is a pretty shot. You know, Matt Foxworthy, this is 2 for 2 now, Matt. He's gotten me some great shots. Yesterday, he had the train going over a creek, and I got compliments on that today. And tonight, now, we got this covered bridge. This is Versailles State Park in Indiana.
While riverboat gambling is attracting people to downtown Lawrenceburg, they aren't staying and shopping. They're simply passing through. And many business owners say they now need the help of city leaders to help fill these vacant storefronts.